Hello everyone, it's Alina, and today I'll share with you guys how I manage my time in university. This is the same method that I used during high school and it's still working pretty well, so yeah, I'm just gonna share with you guys what I do. Now the first thing that I recommend doing has nothing to do with actually scheduling your time. It's something that you should do way ahead of that, and that is map out your goals. You should really know why you want to manage your time well, because if you know why you're doing things, you're much more motivated to end up doing them. I remember last summer I went to a conference and they asked us to make a life plan for up until we're 60, and we should like write down all the things that we want to achieve along the way. And they had like different categories like fitness and well-being, purpose and fulfillment, academia, work, and so on and so on. And you just had to really like think about what you want. And I feel like that really helped me so much. I mean, I already had like a list of like short and long-term goals, but like just mapping out like a little plan, that really helped. I mean, obviously nothing is ever gonna go exactly according to plan in life, but it still helps to have like an ideal plan so that you know what you're working towards. And obviously the things on your plan can change because, you know, you grow as a person and some things become more important to you than others, and maybe you completely change directions, and it's completely fine. But I feel like having sort of like an ideal plan that you can change, but it just helps to, you know, give you some direction in why you do things. Okay, now let's get into like the actual planning and scheduling things. So I think to time management, there's really just two things that you need to tick off. And those is knowing what to do and when you're gonna do it. And it sounds super, super simple, but we all know it actually isn't. So here's what I do. I like to have a notebook where I keep all my to-dos, and I like to have a calendar which I have digitally, and I put down all the meetings, all the lectures, everything I have scheduled in the day, and then I also schedule in my work. Now let's start with the notebook. So I have this Ring agenda which I just use as my notebook, and I find it really useful because you can put in as much paper as you want, you can add sections, etc. But use whatever works for you. Now the way I organize my to-do list, I organize my to-do list by day, and then I just write down all the things that I need to do in that day, and then I mark out what's important. So I can show you guys what it looks like. It's just like I highlight the things that I like super, super urgently need to get done. And those are the things I do first because they matter the most. Because I highlight them, I can immediately see these are the things that I need to do. And really important to me is also that my to-do lists are clean of all other things. Like you can see, there's just my to-dos on this page. There's nothing else. I mean, yeah, okay, there's the day on which I'm doing this, and then the time I'm gonna wake up so that I just know like how much time am I gonna have in this day. And I usually mark down how many bottles of water I drank because it just helps me keep track of am I hydrated enough, because I'm the person who forgets to drink for hours and I just don't realize. But that's it. There's nothing on here like other things that could get me distracted from my to-dos, and I think that's really, really important. Also, this entire notebook is just for work. So like I have a calendar over there, and then I have like some lists of like, for example, like my essentials packing list if I go on a weekend trip so I don't need to write a packing list again and again and again. And stuff like that is all in here. But there is nothing like my favorite TV shows or anything that could distract me in this book. And I think this really just helps to, you know, stay focused when you're working. So have a to-do list book or like an app where you keep all your to-dos, but really use it only for work. Because if there's anything else in there, it's super, super easy to just flip the pages and be like, oh, that's so interesting, let me watch an episode of that. And, you know, then you're out of the workflow. One really important thing about having a book for to-do lists and not an app or something is you need to always, always bring that book with you. And you really, like, need to commit to your notebook. It sounds really silly, but it's really the key to making this thing work. If you think you're not the person who's gonna bring this thing everywhere, that's fine. Then download an app and use that. And put it on your phone and put it on your iPad and your MacBook or whatever you're using, and have it with you. Because in order for your to-do lists to be effective and really have all the to-dos in one place, you need to always have it with you so you can just quickly write it down. If it's not there, you're not gonna write it down, and your to-do list book just becomes sort of unnecessary because you actually have like three different lists and it just becomes useless. So you really, really need to bring it everywhere, and it's really like a commitment, but it also really helps because when you have it with you all the time and you know you're somewhere and like you realize, okay, actually I need to wait here for like half an hour, you can just open up your book and be like, okay, what can I do right now with that half an hour? I would also recommend realistically thinking about whether you're going to remember to do something. Like, for example, I often have things that need to be done by like a certain time of the day, like say 4 p.m. or whatever, and if I know I'm having a really, really busy day with lectures, etc., and I might forget to, you know, just like hit send on a particular email or something, then I like to set myself a reminder with Wunderlist. Wunderlist is super, super useful because you can tell it the day and the exact time you want to be reminded, and then it just delivers the to-do to your email inbox. And that is just lovely. Wunderlist is free and you can use it super, super easily. You can download it on all your devices. And no, this is not sponsored in any way. I just really, really love the app. And I think this is also a really, really great option for those of you who don't want to use a paper to-do list but would rather have something digitally. Having Wunderlist is amazing because you can create different lists, and so you can like organize it by subject or whatever. And you can have subtasks, so you can like, you know, split up your homework into different tasks. And it's just super, super useful. Okay, now let's get to the calendar. Now, as I said, I use the digital calendar. I just use the Apple calendar that comes with any Apple device, and I find that to be the most useful thing for me because you can like import events from emails, etc., and like it just works well for me. And I guess because it's the only digital calendar that I've ever tried, it's just, you know, I'm used to it and I don't want to change. But yeah, like whatever calendar app you're using, just make sure that, you know, it's a convenient one and it's really working efficiently for you. Same as with the notebook, you need to have your calendar always, always with you, because otherwise when someone asks you, oh, like, are you free to meet me on Wednesday at like 5 p.m. say, and you don't know if you're really free, and you're just like, yeah, sure, and maybe you actually scheduled a study session, then, you know, you're actually not really committed to your calendar and your calendar becomes ineffective. So in order for your calendar to be effective, you need to bring it with you all the time. And it's also really important that when you schedule something into your calendar, you don't back out of it. So if you say, okay, I'm gonna study from 4 to 6, you actually have to do that, and you have to hold yourself accountable to that. And your calendar is a way of checking yourself, so always go on it and be like, what should I be doing right now? If you're having free time, great, but if you know that you need to work on, you know, I don't know, a particular essay or whatever, then do that, because otherwise it's gonna come and haunt you down in the evening, and you don't want to be awake until like 1 a.m. just like, you know, cramming about that essay. It's not worth it. So your calendar helps you to know when you have time to do things, but then you actually need to follow through on it. Now, a lot of people actually feel like they don't have enough time to study. So what I like to do is, I like to take my calendar and I schedule in all my lectures and all these things, and then I look at how much time I have for studying, etc. So what I always have in my calendar is my lectures, because, well, they just happen every week, you know? I can't change that and I have to go to them, so yeah. Same for my supervisions, those are classes and I can't just, you know, not show up. Those are an optional thing. Then I look at, you know, how much time I have, I add all my study sessions, and then I add buffer times. And I think buffer times are really, really important, because if you schedule in every free slot that you have just to, you know, like work, and then something takes longer, your entire calendar is messed up. That's why I plan in quite a few buffer times. Now, I'm gonna show you guys what my calendar looked like this week. And now you're probably thinking like, oh gosh, this is a lot of things. Yes, it looks super, super busy, but that's also because I do a lot of extracurriculars. But now let's take away the buffer times. So you can see I already had like a few hours which were just buffer times, and I can tell you this week I basically didn't use my buffer times. So I had free time in those hours, but I had them scheduled in there just in case I might need them, and I didn't. So great, I didn't have to use them, but had I had to use them, I would have had the time to take some more time with some of the things that I did. When you're looking at your calendar, I think it's really important that you're taking away the buffer time and the studying time and just look at what else is in your week, because that tells you how much time you realistically even have for schoolwork. And also ask yourself, is that even enough time? For me, I don't have a lot of time during the week, and I know that. I would like to point out that during the weekend, there's not as much studying scheduled this week because our holiday started. So yeah, normally my weekend would look a little bit different. But I do have to say, I'm someone who's really, really busy under the week because I do a lot of extracurriculars. And so I know that I need to work a lot in the time that I have, and that I can't have, you know, as much free time in terms of like, you know, just chilling with Netflix, etc., because I have a lot of free time in my extracurriculars. Like, I consider my extracurriculars fun, and so they are part of my free time. But obviously you need to check like how much time do you even have to allocate to studying. And that's why I would always use a digital planner, because it's so easy to just, you know, block out certain calendars. And then most importantly, you should at least once a week just take your calendar and turn off every calendar except the free time calendar. And that just makes you check, do you even have free time? That's the first thing. And How much free time do you have? Is it enough? And it's really, really important. Okay, free time should be like just chilling on Netflix, reading a book, or you know, just lying on your bed, whatever you want to do. But it should be scheduled in there so that you actually have it. And this is the time that should never, ever be deleted for anything, okay? Because you should really just enjoy your free time and you really, really need to have it. So that's why I always check with my calendar when I'm done planning my week. I turn off everything except me time and I'm like, okay, is this enough? And if it is, great. If it isn't, then I have to swap things around because I know that otherwise the week is not gonna go very well. Now, as you might have been able to see in my calendar, I do a lot of work in the morning. I usually work like at least 1.5 hours in the morning before I even get breakfast, and I find it really, really useful. But if you have these like longer slots where you do some work, I think it's really important that you have a to-do list because, you know, I usually just write like, for example, civil law reading. And I know what I mean by that, but I need to set myself like a more specific goal because my civil law reading list is like 4 pages long. So that's, you know, unrealistic to be done in 1.5 hours. So I write down, okay, civil law reading list, topic 1, 2, and 3. And something like that. And for me, that just really, really helps. If you guys want to have a template for the to-do list that I write for these like longer study slots, I have that link down below for you guys. I find it really useful to just write one. This template is specifically for my mornings, but you can use it for like any time of the day. And you know, it just helps you keep track of all the things that you want to achieve, like all the little subtasks within the bigger task of, for example, readings for civil law. And lastly, I think it's super, super important that you track your habits. So like, you know, check yourself. Did you go to bed at the time that you were supposed to go to bed? Did you wake up the time you wanted to wake up? Did you finish all the to-dos on your to-do list? And it is super, super easy to do that. I use a habit tracker. I just do that in the evening. And you know, I just go over it like, okay, so did I wake up at 5 a.m. as I wanted to? Did I go to bed before 10 p.m.? And did I finish all the to-dos on my to-do list? And you can then go back and like see, you know, your progress and like, when did you miss out on something? And why, and it just helps you, you know, see if you're on track with what you want to achieve with your time management. And if you aren't on track, you should really, you know, reflect on it. Like, why aren't you on track at the moment? Is there something specific that's keeping you from it? Can you change that? And I think a habit tracker just really helps because it helps give you an overview. And you know, because you usually just remember like the last 2 to 3 days of like whether you completed all your to-dos or whatever. But a habit tracker allows you to go back months and just see if you were successful with your time management. And that's something that for me personally is just really useful, and it's also really rewarding because if you can like hit all the boxes, it's just a really, really nice feeling. And yeah, those are all my tips for time management. I hope this helps some of you guys. If you guys have any questions for me, feel free to drop them in the comments below or send me a message through the contact section of my blog, which is linked below as well. I hope I could help some of you guys, and thank you guys so much for watching. Have a nice day. Bye.